Hello everyone. So today's topic is about how to encrypt your data, and this is a theoretical view, how to encrypt your data and secure your files in S3 bucket. This is one of the this is a bit important topic as per your solution architect exam. So so how do you secure your buckets? By default, all new buckets are private, created buckets are private, that we already saw in our previous lab. And since it's private, it's already secured, and means that there is no public access to it, but you can provide public access by changing the permissions. You can set up access control to your buckets using using bucket policies and access control list. The access control list I've already shown you. Bucket policies means you are giving permission to the whole bucket, to the entire bucket you are giving the permission, and access control list you are giving an permission to a single object, to an to individual objects inside the bucket. Along with this, S3 buckets can be configured to create access logs which logs all requests made to the S3 buckets. This can be done to another bucket. It's written here done. It should be done. This can be done to another bucket, and it can also be done to another AWS account. Encryption. This is a very very this is a very pretty important topic, and you need to know what what all types of encryptions. One of them is in transit. When you are sending information to and from the bucket, it is secured using SSL or TLS. And at rest, these are of two types: server-side encryption and client-side encryption. Now, server-side encryption is also of two types. Server-side encryption is of three types. One is S3 managed, SSE, S3. Here, each object is encrypted with a unique key, employing strong multi-factor encryption. Then, as an additional safeguard, Amazon actually encrypts the key itself as a masked key, and they regularly rotate that masked key. Now Amazon handles all the keys for you. The second one is AWS Key Management Service, or Managed Keys, that is SSE KMS. Here this is same as SSE S3, the first one, SSE Managed Keys, but it comes with few additional benefits and also charges. Separate permission is given for use of envelope key. Now, what is the envelope key? It protects the data encryption key. Thus, it provides added protection towards unauthorized access to your objects in the S3. The main advantage of this SSE KMS is it enables audit trail, and it logs when the keys were used and who used the keys. Now, the third one is server-side encryption with customer-provided key, which is also known as SSC. Here we manage encryption key, and Amazon manages the encryption. So encryption key is managed by the user itself, by us, and the encryption is managed by Amazon. And other type of at-rest encryption is client-side encryption. Here we encrypt the data on client-side and then upload it on S3. So this is all about security and encryption. So our next topic is storage gateway. It is a very very important topic, and it's a theoretical one. So I know it's a bit troublesome for you guys, but please look into this video. AWS Storage Gateway is a service that connects your on-premises software appliance with a cloud-based storage to provide seamless and secure integration between an organization's on-premises IT environment and AWS storage infrastructure. This service enables you to securely store data to the AWS cloud for scalable and cost-effective storage. So you can take this as this one is your data center, and this is a storage gateway media, and this one is your AWS. So storage gateway is basically a virtual appliance that you install into a hypervisor running in your data center, in your data center, and then that virtual appliance will propagate or asynchronously replicate your information up to AWS and particularly to S3. Or if you take lifecycle management, then it will go to Glacier on what storage gateway appliance you are using. So AWS storage gateway software appliance is available for download as a VM image that you install on a host in your data center. Storage gateway supports either VMware ESXi or Microsoft Hyper-V. Once you have installed your gateway and associated it with your AWS account through the activation process, which I showed you earlier itself, how to activate and all, you can use the AWS Management Console to create the storage gateway option that is right for you. So there are basically four types of storage, and previously it was three types, and right now it has become four types. So what are those? Those are file gateway, volume gateway, and taped gateway. And volume gateway has two types: stored volumes and cached volumes. So what is file gateway? File gateway, just you can say file gateway just means through NFS it does, and it stores the flat files like PDF, doc, documents, pictures in your S3. Volume gateway, it uses iSCSI, and it is uses block based storage. It is a block based storage. It uses storage where OS operating system runs, and it is not, it does not use S3 for storage. This volume gateway has two types, as I said, stored volumes and cached volumes. Stored volumes stores the entire copy of your data set on premise, and cache volume stores only recently sort of accessed data on premise, and rest data is backed off into Amazon. And what about taped gateway? It uses VTL, virtual tape library. It is a backup and archiving solution, and to S3, and allows you to create virtual tapes and send them to S3, and then use lifecycle policies to send them off to Glacier. So let's go in detail with file gateway. So what is file gateway? These are, as I already said, it stores flat files, and the files are stored as objects in your S3 buckets, accessed through a NFS mount point. Ownership, permissions, and timestamps are durably stored in S3 in the user metadata of the object associated with the file. Once objects are transferred to S3, they can be managed as native S3 objects, and bucket policies such as versioning, lifecycle management, and cross-region replication apply directly to objects stored in your bucket. So if you take this diagram, this is one of the file gateway diagram. Here you can see, this is the app server, this is your application server, which connects via NFS to your storage gateway. Remember, storage gateway is basically just a virtual machine running on premise on your ESX servers, Hyper-V servers, and then it connects into your AWS. It connects mainly through internet, or there are direct connectivity, or through Amazon VPC. Direct connectivity is basically a dedicated connection it is using. And then in your AWS, if you set the lifecycle management policy, so it will first store in your S3, then it will go ahead to infrequently access S3, and then to Glacier, or you can delete it. So next is volume gateway. This volume interface presents your application with disk volumes using the I/SCSI block protocol. So this is a block-based storage, basically. The data written to these volumes can be asynchronously backed up as a point-in-time snapshots of your volumes and stored in the cloud as Amazon EBS snapshots. In my basics of AWS, I already told EBS is elastic block storage, and this I will be covering in my EC2 section. Currently, we are still in Amazon S3 section we are running, and we have some more topics left in it, after which we will be going ahead with EC2. So snapshots are incremental backups that capture only changed blocks. All snapshots storage is also compressed to minimize your storage charges. So volume gateways are virtual hard disks that you sit and back them up to AWS. And as I already said, the volume gateways are of two types. First is volume gate stored volumes. The stored volumes lets you store your data, primary data, locally while asynchronously backing up that data to AWS. Stored volumes provide your on-premises applications with low latency access to their entire data sets while providing durable off-site backups. You can create stored volumes and mount them as I/SCSI devices from your on-premises application servers. Data written to your stored volumes is stored on your on-premises storage hardware. This data is asynchronously backed up to Amazon EBS snapshot. 1 GB to 16 TB is the size of the stored volumes. So basically, it takes snapshots of your data and sends to S3. Remember, snapshots are incremental. So here, if you look into the diagram, what it happens? This is the so the this is our client users, and it reaches out to the application server, and the application server through I/SCSI network it goes to the storage gateway. Here we have the volume storage and the upload buffer. This gateway VM, these are basically virtual machines or hard disks, and are provisioned by storage gateway. Virtual hard disks are stored on your physical infrastructure. Stored volumes is physical infrastructure, and from here, this data is being transferred to Amazon S3. So stored volume is basically it is 100%, and you can keep your complete volume of data on site, and that is back up incrementally to S3. So next is cached volumes. This is another type of volume gateway. I missed to state one thing in here, is that let me go to the previous slides. These are the new names of these of the stored of the types of storage gateway. Previously, the names were Previously, the names were gateway store. There were three types, as I said earlier: gateway stored volumes, gateway cached volumes, and gateway virtual tape library, along with the file gateway name that is common, that is same itself. The other names have changed in here. So, what is cached volumes? Cached volumes, they lets you use Amazon S3 as your primary data storage, while retaining frequently accessed data locally in your storage gateway. As you means the name suggests, cached. Cache volumes minimizes the need to scale your on-premises storage infrastructure while still providing your apps with applications with low latency access to their frequently accessed data. You can create storage volumes up to 32 terabyte and attach them as iSCSI devices from your on-premises application servers. Your gateway stores data that you write to these volumes in Amazon S3 and retains recently read data in your on-premises storage gateways cache and upload buffer storage. 1 GB to 32 terabyte is the size for cached volumes. So here what happens? The users reaches out to the application server from where it goes to the gateway VM, and it caches the, this is a cached storage. In previous one, you can see this one was volume storage in stored volumes, and here it is a cached storage, here it is kept, and the rest is moved on to the Amazon S3. You don't have to rely on having very large storage arrays, as most of your data is being stored in AWS. You're only keeping the recently read data in here. And the next one is tape gateway. Tape gateway, this offers a durable, cost-effective solution to archive your data in AWS cloud. The virtual tape library interface, VTL is virtual tape library interface, it provides lets you leverage your existing tape-based backup application infrastructure to store data on virtual tape cartridges that you create on pre-configured with a media changer and tape drives, which are available to your existing client backup applications such as iSCSI devices. You add tape cartridges as you need to archive your data. This is supported by net backup. This is supported by net backup, backup exe, Veeam, etc. VEEAM, Veeam. So here what happens? You have your backup application, let it be something, and through iSCSI network it moves to the gateway VM, from where it is moved to the virtual tape backed up by Amazon S3, and depending upon your lifecycle policy, it is then moved to the virtual tape shelf, which is Amazon Glacier, supported by Amazon Glacier. So this concludes the section. You can get some scenario based questions, like if you need to store whole bunch of your flat files and keep storage cost to minimum, which one will you use? Then it should be file gateway. And if you have your, let's say, assume if you have your own data center and you are doing backups on your servers using net backup, and you got a physical tape library. Tapes are being stored in Iron Mountain, and but you need to save some money. How can you virtualize this? That time you need to go with this one, gateway VTL, virtual tape library. You are a media company and you got, assume you got, you have lots of amounts of data storage, but you don't want to keep them on site. all the time. That time you need to go with cached volumes. And if you are a financial company and you need to keep the latency down to a minimum, you got to keep the data on site at the same time, you need to back up that data to cloud. That time you need to go with stored volumes. So this concludes our section. So right now we are left with two topics, which is Amazon Glacier. In S3 we are left with two topics. One is Amazon Glacier and the other one is transfer acceleration, which I will be covering in the next video. So if you are liking this video, please do subscribe, like. If you like my work, please do subscribe, like, and share it. Thank you.